Hello, everyone. My name is Duwan Booker. I'm a seminarian with the Diocese of Little Rock, and I'm studying theology here in my first year at Assumption Seminary. I've had the privilege and the honor of being able to serve the good people of Holy Redeemer Catholic Church under the direction of Father Kevin Fouts. This is the Thursday Gospel reading after Ash Wednesday. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke. Jesus said to his disciples, "The Son of Man must suffer greatly and be rejected by the elders, the chief priests, and the scribes, and be killed and on the third day be raised." Then he said to all, "If anyone wishes to come after me, he must deny himself, take up his cross daily, and follow me. For whoever wishes to save his life will lose it, but whoever loses his life for my sake will save it. What profit is there for one to gain the whole world, yet lose or forfeit himself?" The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. And so the first thing that comes to mind for me is that in order to truly follow Jesus, we must be willing to take up our cross daily. Jesus warns of his impending suffering whenever he says that the Son of Man must suffer, and he will be rejected by the chief priests and the scribes and killed, and on the third day be raised again. And so we in following after Christ must be willing to do the same thing. Are we willing to be rejected? Are we willing to suffer? Are we willing to die to ourselves? And do we have trust and hope in the Lord that he will raise us up on the third day? You know, whenever I was thinking about this passage, I was thinking about the bad circumstances that are going on right now throughout the entire state of Texas. When you have millions of people without power, some in the cold, some without running water, people unable to do simple tasks such as flush their toilets. And I thought about this passage in relation to that, and I just thought, you know, sometimes we're going to have suffering in this life. And suffering is not an easy topic to talk about. It's not an easy thing to go through. But Jesus went before us in his suffering, and so we can relate to him in our suffering. And so knowing that Christ has gone before us and Christ has experienced suffering while he was on earth ought to give us hope, ought to give us joy, ought to give us a sense of perseverance that he is with us in our suffering here and that we can overcome it. And that even death shouldn't be a thing for us to fear, because we know that we shall be raised up on the third day. Jesus says, whoever wishes to save his life will lose it. Whoever loses his life for my sake will save it. In the spirit of Lent, what in our lives can we, if we examine our lives and examine our daily actions, what is it that we're trying to save? What is it that we're not willing to give up to the Lord? What is it that we're not willing to say, God, I invite you into this part of my life. I give you this hobby. I give you this desire of my heart. We have to be willing to allow the Lord to really penetrate every aspect of our lives and to not hold anything separate of him, so that we can be transformed and then recreated. You know, God comes and he wants to regenerate our spirits and to send us forth in order to serve others. And so what areas of our lives are in the way of that? Is it our TV shows? Is it our hobbies? Is it social media? We have to be willing to really examine ourselves and to think, wherever God is not in my life, I want to get rid of, because I want God to be everywhere I look. And so are we willing to give up that comfort? Are we willing to give up that security? Are we willing to give up that sense of that sense of our desires and our values that we have? We must not have fear in any of this. And I know it's very difficult when one examines his or her own life in order to be fearful of change. But one thing that we know is that Jesus promises that he'll take care of us and he'll be with us as he's already gone before us. You know, that's the crazy thing about the Christian life and the spiritual journey, is that as we seek after Jesus, he stands before us, having gone before already, but yet he's also next to us because he's there with us. And then he's also behind us, making sure that we don't stumble and fall. And so we can have joy today on this Thursday morning, knowing that God is with us in our struggles. God is with us in our temptations. God is with us in our trials, and that he has already said on the third day we'll be raised up. And so we must be willing to deny ourselves, our own wants, our own desires, our own hobbies, anything within us that is not of God, we must ask him to take it away and to purge it so that we may be free. We may be free to love, worship, and serve him and his people. And then we know, we ought to know that our world needs us. You know, that's the crazy thing about the spiritual life is that it's not just for ourselves. We can't be selfish in our own salvation. The salvation of the world depends on what you and I do today. It depends on how we pray. It depends on how we live. It depends on how charitable we are. Your mother depends on it. Your father depends on it. Your sister, your brother, your neighbor, the cashier at the gas station. Everyone depends on our ability to stay connected with the Father and to be able to serve and to love those around us. Our world needs us. Our world needs us as Christians to really tap into our faith and to authentically live out the gospel so that we can